So are you ready? Are we ready?
Yeah, ready. But Janaka Prabhu is not here yet.
Janaka is not here. Do we need to wait for him?
Just one moment, Mari. I cannot hear you just now. I turned to the earphone, but I cannot hear. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Sorry. Start now or wait for Janaka Prabhu?
Well, we can start, I think.
Okay. Please.
Namo Vishnu Padaya Krishna Pristaya Bhutale Srimati Bhakti Vedanta Swami Iti Namane Namaste Sarasati Devi Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Sunyavadi Paschacha Deshatarine Vanchakaupatarubhyascha kripasindhubhayavacha patitanam pavanibhyo vaishnavibhyo namo namaha. Jai Jai Sri Chaitanya Jaya Nityananda Jaya Dvaita Chandra Jaya Gaur Bhaktavinda.
Jaya Jaya Sri Chaitanya Jaya Nityananda
Jai Jai Sri Chaitanya Jaya Nityananda Jaya Dvaita Chandra Jaya Gaur Bhaktavinda.
Jaya Jaya Sri Chaitanya Jaya Nityananda Jaya Dvaita Chandra Jaya Gaur Bhaktavinda.
Jai Jai Sri Chaitanya Jaya Nityananda Jaya Dvaita Chandra Jaya Gaur Bhaktavinda.
Jaya Jaya Sri Chaitanya Jaya Nityananda Jaya Dvaita Chandra Jaya Gaur Bhaktavinda.
So we're narrating the pastimes of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu as they are described in the Madhya Lila of the Chaitanya Charitamrita. And we heard how Lord Chaitanya had come down to the place on the banks of the Godavari and he met with Ramananda Roy. And there they discussed topics of Radha and Krishna. And Lord Chaitanya was so happy to have in the association of Ramananda Roy that he told Ramananda Roy, he said, I want you to leave this job and come back and just stay with me in Jagannath Puri. Chaitanya said, first I'm going to South India, I'm going further south, I'm going to visit some more holy places. And when I come back, I'll come back here and we can go to Jagannath Puri. Maribo.
Oh, sorry, Mari, I didn't hear you.
Okay.
Maribo.
So, Lord Chaitanya told Ramananda Rai that I'm going to go to visit some more holy places And then I will return here. And when I return here, we can both go back to Jagannath Puri. And we will spend the rest of our lives together in Jagannath Puri discussing the topics of Krishna. So then Lord Chaitanya left the company of Ramananda Rai and he went south. He was traveling along, and there was only one servant with him. That servant was a Brahmana named Krishna Das. So they would go and visit all the temples on the way. They're passing wherever they go, they'd see a temple, they'd go and visit the temple, offer their obeisances. Now the people of South India, many of them were devotees of Lord Ramachandra and they were worshipping Lord Ramachandra. Hari Bol.
Hari Bol, my connection is not good.
Yeah. Where are you? Are you in the Beijing center?
But I use just one moment, Maharaj. I need to change it to another.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare.
Saradira, Saradira, 你那边网络又不行了。
Yeah, she had a bad connection.
其他的翻译，看谁能够接一下吗？
Tosi Gopinath Shangban.
我可以, Haribo.
好。
Okay, so we were explaining in South India, most of nearly the devotees down there in South India, they're devotees of Lord Ramachandra, and there's many temples of Lord Ramachandra. There are two groups of Vaishnavas. One group is from the Ramanuja Vaishnava. They are called the Sri Vaishnavas. They are called the Sri Vaishnava. Sri is the name of Lakshmi because their disciplic succession comes from Lakshmi. And then you have the other group of Vaishnavas. They're from the Madhvacharya line. And they are known as the Tattvavadis.
祖奉献者是来自 Madhvacharya 的传记，被称为 Tadvavadi。
Yeah, the followers of Shankaracharya, they're called Mayavadi.
Shankaracharya 的追随者被称为 Mayavadi.
So the followers of Madhvacharya often debate with the followers of Shankaracharya.
Madhvacharya 的追随者常常和 Shankaracharya 的追随者展开辩论。
So the followers of Madhvacharya got the name Tattvavadis.
因此 Madhvacharya 的追随者就以 Tattvavadi 而驰名。
So, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was traveling in South India along with his servant Krishna Das, and they went to the temple, a temple of Lord Ramachandra.
Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 就和他的仆人 Krishna Das 一起旅行到了一个
So Lord Chaitanya is a sannyasi. So when he would go to the temple, people would often invite him to come and take lunch at their home. So one Brahmana saw Lord Chaitanya, and he invited Lord Chaitanya to come to his home and take lunch.
这时候来了一位 Brahmana, 就邀请主 Chaitanya 到自己家中来进餐。
And this Brahmana, he did not speak a word. All he did was chant the holy name of Lord Ramachandra.
这位 Brahmana 他不说话，他只是一味的唱诵 Ramachandra 的名字。
You know, we like to chant Hare Krishna. The followers of Lord Rama, they will chant Rama, 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 Rama. Sometimes they will chant Sitaram, Sitaram.
我们唱诵 Hare Krishna, 而他们 Ramachandra 的奉献者就会不停地唱诵 Rama, Rama, Rama. 有的时候他们念的是 Sita Rama, Sita Rama.
So Lord Ramachandra took prasadam at his house and gave mercy to the Brahmana, and then he left.
主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 就来到这位 Brahmana 的家中进餐，给予他仁慈之后，然后就离开了。
So again, he visited different places, and then he came back again to visit the same place where that Brahmana was. He had been chanting the name of Lord Rama.He came back, Lord Chaitanya came back again, and he visited the house of the Brahmana, but this time he saw the Brahmana was now chanting the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra.
Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 又去了别的地方旅行，之后他又返回了这位 Brahmana 所在的庙宇，他又来到了这位 Brahmana 的家中做客。他发现这一回，这位 Brahmana 开始唱诵 Hare Krishna.
Before he'd only been chanting Rama, the name of Ram, but now he's chanting the Hare Krishna mantra. So Lord Chaitanya asked him, "What happened?"
在此之前，这位 Brahmana 一直在唱诵 Rama 的名字，可是他现在改成了唱诵 Hare Krishna.所以主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 就问他到底发生了什么。
So the Brahmana said, he said, "This is because of you, due to your influence." He said, "After I saw you, I've lost my practice of my I've been chanting the name of Ram all my life, but since seeing you, I've started chanting Hare Krishna mantra.
这位Brahmana说，自从我见到你之后，由于你的影响，我在此之前我一辈子都在念诵Rama的名字，可是见到你之后，我就开始念诵Hare Krishna的名字了。
I just chanted the name of Krishna one time, but after I chanted it, the name it won't leave me. It can't stop. It's always on my tongue.
我只是念诵了Krishna的名字一次，可是在就念诵一次之后，Krishna的名字就再也离不开我的舌尖了，它就一直就留在我的舌尖上，我就一直不停的开始念诵Krishna的名字。
And now I see the name of Lord Ram has gone far away.
现在我看到 Rama 的名字已经走得远远的了。
He said, from my childhood, I've been collecting scriptures, verses from the scriptures about the glories of the holy name.
从我的童年时代起，我就一直阅读到有关于圣名的荣耀的经典。
Right, and the Brahmana showed Lord Chaitanya, he had some verses. Ramante yogino nante sarvananda kadatmani, like this, there are verses. He had a verse from the scriptures that the absolute truth is called Rama.
This Brahmana
just
chanted the verse. 这个世界的意思是绝对真理被称为Rama.
It's called Rama because there's so much pleasure in the spiritual existence.
它之所以被以Rama著称，是因为在灵性的存在当中蕴含着无穷无尽的快乐。
Then he had another name about Krishna. Another verse from the scriptures about the holy name of Krishna. He said, Krish, the word Krish is the feature, attractive feature of the Lord. And Na means spiritual pleasure. So when Krish is added to Na, it becomes Krishna, and it means the absolute truth.
Krish放在那之前, 就合成了Krishna, 它就指着绝对的真理。
The holy name of Rama and Krishna are on the same level, they're equal.
Rama和Krishna这两个圣名是处在同一个平等的层面上。
But we get some information from the scriptures, giving more details.
在经典当中还有更多的细节。
So then the Brahmana quotes a famous verse about Lord Shiva speaking to his wife, Durga.
之后这位Brahmana又引述了主Shiva向他的妻子Durga
女神讲述了一句著名的话：“Ramo Rameti Rameti Rame Rame Namo Rame Sahasranam Abhistoyam Ramanama Varanine。” That Lord Shiva said to his wife, he says, "Oh, beautiful woman, Varanana, I chant the holy name of Ram. And I enjoy the beautiful sound. This holy name of Rama is equal to 1,000 holy names of Lord Vishnu. Then there's another verse that says, the results of chanting 1,000 names of Vishnu three times can be obtained when you chant the holy name of Krishna. So 3,000 names of Vishnu is equal to one name of Krishna. According to the scriptures, the holy name of Krishna is is unlimitedly powerful. But the Brahmana said, still, I could not chant the holy name. I had been the devotee of Lord Rama and chanted his holy name, and I got happiness from his name. Because I got happiness from chanting his name, I chanted the name of Lord Ram day and night. But when you came here, you were the holy name of Lord Krishna also appeared. So the holy name of Krishna awoke in my heart. And then the Brahmana said to Lord Chaitanya, I think you are Lord Krishna himself. This is my understanding.
And
so then the Brahmana fell at the feet of Lord Chaitanya. So Lord Chaitanya gave mercy to the Brahmana, and then he left and went to some more holy places. Wherever the Lord went, he would attract many people. Many people would come to see this very special sannyasi. South Indian people were influenced by many different philosophies. But Lord Chaitanya would defeat all of them with his powerful arguments. He came, said, these people of South India, they were all strong like elephants, but they were in the grip of the crocodile of bogus philosophies.
些南印度人他们都像大象一样强有力，然而他们却被那些像鳄鱼一样假的哲学所被这些像鳄鱼一样假的哲学抓住，牢牢抓住了。
But Lord Chaitanya appeared with his Sudarshan Chakra by presenting the powerful arguments of his philosophy. He could defeat all of them and give them Krishna consciousness.
就柴丹尼亚，他带着自己的 Sudarshan Chakra 神蝶武器，他用他的哲学就击败了所有这些论点。
So wherever he went, Lord Chaitanya was making people into Vaishnavas.
So, 无论主柴丹尼亚去哪里，都把人们转变成了 Vaishnava.
And sometimes great atheists would hear about Lord Chaitanya, and they would come and they would bring their disciples with them, and they would try to challenge Lord Chaitanya.
有的时候一些了不起的无神论者就带着他们的门徒前来向主柴丹尼亚挑战。
So in the time of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, there was quite a few Buddhists present in India, and there was one leader of the Buddhist cult, and he came to challenge Lord Chaitanya.
在主柴丹尼亚马哈布的时代，有几位很有影响力的佛教徒。其中有一天就来了一位佛教大师，就带着他的门徒向主柴丹尼亚来挑战。
Yeah, this Buddhist master was a very learned scholar, and he came with all his disciples to challenge Lord Chaitanya.
这位佛教大师呢，他是一个很学识渊博的学者，他就带领着自己所有众多的门徒就来挑战主柴丹尼亚。
In the Chaitanya Charitamrita, it says Buddhists are unfit. They're unfit for discussion. They're not good to argue with. It's not good to talk with them. Haribo? Hare Krishna, what happened? What happened?
Mama, can you repeat?
Yeah, I said that in the Chaitanya Charitamrita, it says devotees don't want to see the Vaishnavas, and we don't like to discuss philosophy with them.
You mean the Buddhists don't want to see Vaishnava, or Vaishnava don't want to see the Buddhists?
Vaishnava don't want, they don't want to see the Buddhists.
Oh, okay. 在 Chaitanya Charitamrita 当中就说 Vaishnava 他们不想见到那些佛教徒，也不喜欢跟他们讨论哲学。
But Lord Chaitanya gave them mercy just to take away their pride.
可是主 Chaitanya 给予他们仁慈，只是为了将把他们的骄傲拿出，铲除他们的骄傲。
The teachings of the Buddhists are all based on argument and logic.
佛教的教导，他们的基础全是建立在那些论点、辩论的基础之上。
But Lord Chaitanya defeated all of their arguments.
但是主柴丹尼亚把他们所有的论点都一一击败了。
They could not make any impression on Lord Chaitanya.
们不能对主彩蛋娘，给主彩蛋娘留下任何印象。
The Buddhist master was trying to explain the Buddhist principles, but Lord Chaitanya defeated all their arguments with his logic.
这位佛教大师就是试图用他，试图向主彩蛋娘宣讲所有那些佛教的原则，但是主彩蛋娘用逻辑就将这些佛教的原则一一击败了。
Yeah, the Buddhist master was just a speculator. Although he was a scholar, it was all based on speculation.
虽然这位佛教大师是一个学者，但是他的所有的论点全都是建立在推敲、心智推敲的基础之上。
And when Lord Chaitanya defeated everything they said, the people who were there, they began to laugh. And the Buddhist teacher felt very ashamed. So then the Buddhists, they could understand Lord Chaitanya was a Vaishnava. So they were very unhappy.
这些佛教徒就明白主彩蛋娘妈妈布是一位 Vaishnava, 因此他们都闷闷不乐。
So they made a plan to try to get some revenge on Lord Chaitanya.
他们就密谋要报复主彩蛋娘妈妈布。
And they brought a plate, a big plate, with untouchable food, and they brought it before Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and they said, this is Mahaprasadam. This is important because devotees, Vaishnavas, devotees, we cannot take any food which is cooked by non-devotees. Lord Chaitanya was one time asked, what is the behavior of a Vaishnava? And Lord Chaitanya said, a Vaishnava will avoid the company of non-devotees. Prabhupada said, devotees must be very strict about this and not associate intimately with people who are not devotees. Even if some non-devotee comes and offers food, and says this is Mahaprasadam, we cannot accept it. Prasadam, somebody who is not a devotee, they cannot offer anything to Krishna.
如果一个人他不是奉献者的话，他是无法向 Krishna 供奉的。
If the food is offered to the deity, it can be taken.
倘若食物被供奉给神像的话，是可以接受的。
But ordinary food cooked by a non-devotee should not be taken by a devotee.
但是一位非奉献者所烹调的普通食物，一位奉献者是不能接，不应该去吃掉这样的食物。
Somebody may be a vegetarian and they may be very clean, but if they're not devotee, they cannot offer food to Krishna.
有的人也许是一位素食者，而且是很清洁的，但是他是无法向主 Krishna.
It cannot.
And he cannot offer food to Krishna.
No.
Right?
No, cannot.
啊，但是即便是这样的人，也是无法向主 Krishna 供奉食物。
Because he's not a devotee, Krishna won't accept.
因为他并非奉献者，所以主 Krishna 是不会接受他的食物，他供奉的食物的。
So the devotee should not accept the food.
因此，一位奉献者是不会接受这样的食物的。
What to do in such a situation?
那在这种情况下该怎么办呢？
You can take fruit, uncut fruit.
在这种情况下可以吃没有，就是没有切过的水果，当时就完整的水果是可以吃的。
Yeah, just take some fruit. You don't need to eat cooked food. Take fruit.
所以不要吃那些烹调的食物，只是吃水果，而且是完整的水果，没有切割过的。
So this Buddhist monk came with a big plate of what he said was Mahaprasadam to offer to Lord Chaitanya.
所以这位佛教大师就携带着这一大盘，宣自称是 Mahaprasadam 的食物，就来到主 Chaitanya 们。
And then a big bird appeared and picked up the plate in his beak and flew away.
这时候飞来一只大鸟，巨鸟，就用它的船就叼起了这个盘子飞走了。
But when the bird was flying away, it dropped the plate and the plate fell on the head of the Buddhist teacher.
这只大鸟就叼着这个盘子就飞到半空当中，然后突然一下子松开了这个盘子，这个盘子一下就掉在了这个佛教大师的额头上。
It was a heavy metal plate, and it cut the head of the teacher, and he fell down unconscious.
这个盘子是用重金属所做成的。他就重重的击倒了这个佛教大师，这个佛教大师就失去了知觉。
So when the teacher fell unconscious, then all of his disciples began to cry, and they all came to Lord Chaitanya and they asked for mercy from him.
就当他的门徒看到了自己的老师失去知觉倒在地上的时候，都哭起来了，都大声的惊叫起来。他们就纷纷的来到主柴丹娘面前，恳求他的仁慈。
They prayed to Lord Chaitanya, please forgive us for our offense.
他们向主柴丹娘祈求道，请宽恕我们的冒犯吧。
Please give mercy on us and bring our teacher back to life.
请给我们仁慈，让我们的老师起死复生吧。
So Lord Chaitanya told them, he said, well, you should all chant the holy name of Krishna and Hari and chant loudly in the ear of your teacher.
主柴丹尼亚就告诉他们，你们应该都唱诵 Krishna 的圣名，大声的就在你们老师的耳边唱诵 Hari。
And if you do like this, if you chant the holy name in his ear, your teacher will get back his consciousness.
如果你们就这样做，在你们老师的耳边唱诵圣名的话，他就能恢复知觉了。
So all the Buddhist disciples, they came around their teacher and they began to all chant, Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna.
这些佛教徒就围着他们的老师，就在他的耳边就唱诵 Krishna, Hare Krishna.
Rama, Hare Rama. They were all chanting the holy name. And when they chanted, then the Buddhist teacher came back to life. He got back his consciousness.
他们唱着 Rama, Hare Rama. 他们就这样唱的圣名，这样就这样用圣名把他们的老师又使他们老师恢复了知觉。
And the teacher, he also chanted Hare Krishna, Hare Rama.
这位佛教大师也开始唱着 Hare Krishna, Hare Rama.
So Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati explains to us, he said, actually Lord Chaitanya, he told these Buddhist disciples of the teacher, he told them to chant Hare Krishna. So when he told them to chant, he was giving them initiation into the chanting.
Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati 他解释说，当主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 命令这些佛教徒唱诵圣名的时候，实际上就已经启迪了他们。
Yeah, because Lord Chaitanya told them, you chant, and they chanted, so this was their initiation. To give the holy name, get the holy name from the teacher, this is actual initiation. So they were not actually Buddhists anymore. They'd become Vaishnavas because they were chanting. And then they went and chanted to their guru. So they gave initiation to their guru. So the disciples became the guru.
接着呢，这些门徒们又到他们guru，他们大师的，他们的佛教老师的耳边唱诵圣名，他们就变成他们的佛教老师的guru了。
So the guru became the disciple of his disciples.
所以这位guru变成了他的门徒的门徒。
Right. The guru saves the devotee from, the guru saves the disciple from the material world by giving him the holy name, the Maha Mantra.
Guru 把门徒从物质存在当中解救出来，是通过给予他们 Maha Mantra 将门徒从物质存在当中拯救出来了。
This is Diksha, this is initiation. You get the holy name, pure knowledge.
This is Diksha, 得到圣名，得到纯粹的知识。
So this was the disciplic succession.
这就是使徒传系。
So Lord Chaitanya gave mercy to the Buddhists and made them into devotees. So when they saw the teacher of the Buddhists chant the holy name of Krishna and surrender to Krishna, all the people there were very amazed. And then Lord Chaitanya just suddenly disappeared from there. Nobody knew where he'd gone.
随后主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 突然从原地消失了。 没有人知道他去了哪里。
Doesn't want a lot of people following him.
他并不希望有很多人追随在他身后。
So everywhere Lord Chaitanya went, he would chant the holy name and dance, and people would be attracted. They would all love to see the chanting and the dancing.
无论主产他娘去哪里，他都唱诵起舞，人们都非常的喜欢看到主产他娘的唱歌和跳舞。
Just like where devotees go traveling, sometimes we go around traveling, visiting places in India, and wherever we go, we perform Sankirtan, it always attracts people.
就像奉献者去印度，无论去哪里，奉献者都会在那里唱歌跳舞，都会纷纷吸引当地的印度人。
So Lord Chaitanya, he was pioneering, he was the first person to begin the Sankirtan movement, to take the chanting of the holy name everywhere, and we are following in his footsteps.
Lord Chaitanya is Sankirtan Hindu 的先锋，他是无论去哪里他都唱诵起舞，我们在追随的是 Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的步伐。
So Lord Chaitanya visited many temples. After a long time, he came to this temple of the biggest Vaishnava temple, which is in South India. It's in Sri Rangam.
Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 就拜访了许多的圣地。之后他来到了印度最大的 一所庙宇，南印度最大的一所庙宇叫 Sri Ranga 庙。
Yeah, it's a big temple, a very ancient temple, established a long time ago, and there are seven walls around the temple.
这所庙宇非常的宏伟，历史悠久。它的四周有七重外墙。
There was one devotee there who used to serve in that temple. She was an incarnation of the goddess of fortune.
有一位奉献者，他以前就在那里做服务，他是幸运女神的化身。
And she was married to the deity. She became the wife of Lord Ranganath, the deity, Vishnu.
她嫁给了这所庙的神像，就变成了 Vishnu 的妻子。
And then later on, her body actually entered into the body of the deity.
后来实际上她的身体就进入了神像的身体。
So Ramanujacharya, he became the in charge of that temple about 1,000 years ago.
大约一千年前 ，Ramanujacharya 就接管了这所庙宇。
And Ramanujacharya, he lived for 130 years.
Ramanujacharya 在世130年。
They say his body is still preserved there inside the temple.
他们说他的身体仍然保存在庙宇里面。
So Lord Chaitanya came to the temple. He is very happy to see Lord Ranganath, and he chanted and danced.
Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 特别，他来到这个庙宇的时候兴高采烈，他就载歌载舞。
So then the Brahmana, everybody was attracted when they saw him chanting and dancing. So the one Brahmana came and invited Lord Chaitanya to come to his home.
庙宇里的人们看到主柴丹尼亚载歌载舞都非常的高兴，这时候来了一位Brahmana，邀请主柴丹尼亚到自己的家中做客。
And Lord Chaitanya went to his home, and the Brahmana, this Brahmana, he was a priest in the temple, and he was a priest, and he was very respectful to Lord Chaitanya.
This Brahmana, 实际上是这所庙宇当中的祭司。
And he washed the feet of Lord Chaitanya and put the water on the head of all of his family. And then he served Lord Chaitanya a very nice lunch.
之后他就给主差的那样准备了一顿丰盛的午餐。
And then he told Lord Chaitanya, he said, Chaturmasya has just come. It's just now is the beginning of Chaturmasya. So why don't you come and stay here? You stay for the whole Chaturmasya, stay here, and you can tell us about Krishna every day.
这位Brahmana对主柴丹尼亚说， Chaturmasya 四月雨季马上就要开始了，为什么不在我家过这个四月雨季的四个月呢？ 这样您可以给我们讲述 Krishna 的体质。
你是打电话进来的还是上网进来的？我是在同学会议。就是你是打电话参加的这个会议，还是上网熟会议号进来这个会议？熟会议号。啊，那你应该看得到，你是有视频的吧？看得到这个？看得到。 显示你的是一个手机号码，因为你打电话进来。嗯，我也不太会，反正它是自动的。它有好多种加入方式，你像有的在国外的，他们只是打电话参会。我就是输入会议号，然后再把密码输进去。
Okay, so So this family were very happy to have Lord Chaitanya come and stay for the Chaturmasya at their home.
这一家人, 他们非常高兴, 因为主产丹亚, 就在Chaturmasya期间就停留在他们家中。
And they said to Lord Chaitanya, we want you to speak to us about Lord Krishna's pastimes.
他们对主产丹亚说道, 我们希望您给我们讲述主 Krishna的逍遥时光。
When you go there, if you go there to Sri Rangam, you can see the place where Lord Chaitanya stayed.
如果你们去Sri Rangam的话, 你们可以亲眼见到主产丹亚停留的地方。
And the descendants of that family are still living there.
就是这个家的后裔后代至今仍然生活在那里。
And they have some Jagannath deities. There's some Jagannath deities. They said Lord Chaitanya personally worshipped these deities when he was staying there.
崇拜着就是加德纳的神像，他们说当主产丹亚拉巴布在那里的时候呢，这些神像是主产丹亚亲自所崇拜的神像。
So Lord Chaitanya, he stayed there and he was very happy. He enjoyed discussing topics of Krishna with their family.
当主产丹亚在他们家中的时候，他很高兴能和这一家人能够讨论谈论 Krishna 的题旨。
Every day he'd take his bath. There's a holy river there, the Kaveri. And he would take a bath there and then go and see the deity of Lord Ranganath, and he would dance in the kirtan. He would chant and dance.
就是他每天都会去卡维瑞圣河沐浴，之后他就进入庙宇去见Sri Ranga神像，然后就在庙宇当中载歌载舞。
And because of Lord Chaitanya's chanting and dancing, everybody who was unhappy or in distress, they would become happy as soon as they saw Lord Chaitanya chanting and dancing.
看到主产丹亚载歌载舞，他们的烦恼和悲伤也都烟消云散了，一扫而空。
And after they saw Lord Chaitanya chant, they would also chant Hare Krishna mantra.
当他们聆听到主产丹亚的唱诵之后，他们也开始唱诵 Hare Krishna.
They didn't chant anything else except the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. Everybody became a Krishna devotee.
除了Hare Krishna Maha Mantra 之外，他们别的什么也不唱，也不念诵，他们全都变成了Krishna的奉献者。
And every day some Brahmana family would invite Lord Chaitanya to their home to come and take lunch. Yeah, every day had an invitation from different places.
每一天都会有 Brahmana 前来邀请主产丹亚到自己的家中做客进餐。就这样，就不同地方的人们 Brahmana 就会纷纷来邀请主产丹亚。So,
when Lord Chaitanya would go to the temple, he would see there's one Brahmana there. Every day there was this one Brahmana who was reciting the Bhagavad Gita, and he would read the whole Bhagavad Gita every day.
当主产丹亚在这个庙宇期间，他每天都在庙宇当中看见一位Brahmana在那里诵读薄伽梵歌。
And he would read all the 18 chapters for, he would read them in great ecstasy. He was feeling so much ecstasy. People could see his hair standing on end and trembling of the body and tears of love, these transcendental symptoms.
这位 Brahmana 呢，就会诵读整部十八章的国家梵歌。人们庙宇当中的人们，亲眼目睹了这位 Brahmana 的狂喜，看见他就毛发直竖，身体颤抖，泪如雨泻。But
he couldn't pronounce the words very correctly. He was not so well educated, so when he would read it, he couldn't read it very well, and people would laugh about him.
但是他的发音读音并不是非常的准确，因为他没有受过教育，所以当人们听到他诵读国家梵歌的时候，他们会嘲笑他。Some
people criticized him, some laughed at him, but he didn't care. He didn't worry. He was so happy to read the Bhagavad Gita.
有的人对他冷嘲热讽，还有的人对他横加指责，可是他都不在意，他只是在那里狂喜的诵读着《不加梵歌》。So
when Lord Chaitanya saw him, how he was doing this every day, and how every day he was so happy, with so much ecstasy reading Bhagavad Gita, Lord Chaitanya was very happy.
主彩丹的妈巴布，他看到这位Brahmana每天在那里狂喜当中诵读国家梵歌，主彩丹的妈巴布心满意足。We
can see from this that the qualification for reading the Bhagavad Gita, it's not material. You have to please Krishna by devotion.
我们从这个事件当中可以看到。 诵读《国家梵歌》的资格不是物质的资格，必须是要怀着奉爱取悦 Krishna.
Even though the Brahmana could not say the words or pronounce the words of the Bhagavad Gita correctly, but he was feeling so much ecstasy.
即便这位 Brahmana 不能正确的发音。
So Lord Chaitanya didn't worry about his pronunciation. He was pleased with his devotion.
主Chaitanya对于这位Brahmana的读音并没有很在乎，他关注的是这位Brahmana的奉爱之情。Yeah,
we have to have devotion. To approach Krishna. Krishna is conquered by devotion. So one day Lord Chaitanya spoke to the Brahmin and he asked him, he said, my dear sir, why are you in so much ecstasy? What's the cause of your ecstasy? Which person in the Bhagavad Gita gives you so much pleasure? Which portion, which section of the Bhagavad Gita gives you so much pleasure?
主彩丹娘，有一天，主彩丹娘，妈妈不就对这位Brahmana说话：“我亲爱的Brahmana，是什么让你感受到这么多的狂喜？” 是《国家梵歌》的哪一部分让你感到狂喜的？Some
people they felt like very much to read about the universal form, and Arjuna offering his prayers to Krishna when he sees the universal form.
有的人就对《国家梵歌》的第十一章宇宙形体特别感兴趣，特别喜欢这一章。 主，Arjuna 向主 Krishna 见到主 Krishna 的宇宙群体之后就献上了祈祷。
And some people, they like to read chapter 15 because that's Purushottam Yoga and this is Purushottam Mass. So sometimes for Purushottam Mass, they will read the chapter 15 every day.
有的奉献者特别喜欢《薄伽梵歌》的第十五章 Purushottam Yoga， 因为现在是 Purushottam 月，有的奉献者就是每天都会在这每天都会朗读第十五章。
And some people, they like to read chapter 12 because that's all about devotional service.
有的人特别的钟爱第十二章，第十二章是奉献服务。
So Lord Chaitanya was curious. He wanted to know which portion of the Bhagavad Gita does this Brahmana like.
主 Chaitanya 妈妈特别好奇，想知道这位 Brahmana 喜欢哪一章。
So the Brahmana told Lord Chaitanya, he said, I'm illiterate, I don't know the meaning of the words.
This Brahmana told Lord Chaitanya, I'm a literate, I don't know the meaning of the words.
He said, sometimes I read it correctly and sometimes not. But I do it because my guru told me to do it.
有的时候我能正确的朗读出来，但有的时候呢，我却无法正确的朗读。我之所以朗读，是因为我的咕噜命令我朗读。
So, this is important point. The order of the spiritual master. When you follow the order of the spiritual master, then it helps us to get. We can get success.
这一点对我们来说是非常有教育意义的。当门徒遵循灵性导师的命令的时候，他的生命就成功了。
The activities don't depend on correct pronunciation. It depend on devotion.
这个活动是并不依赖于发音。而是取决于一个人的奉爱程度。
And devotion means following the order of the spiritual master.
奉爱的意思就是遵守灵性导师的命令。
Without following the order of the spiritual master, then we can never understand the Bhagavad Gita or any scripture.
不遵守灵性导师的命令，我们永远无法理解《薄伽梵歌》，也无法理解任何一部经典。
So if we want to be successful in spiritual life, it begins by following the order of the spiritual master.
如果一个人想在灵性生命当中取得成功，就要从遵守灵性导师的命令开始。
So then the Brahmana told Lord Chaitanya, he said, actually, I see Lord Krishna sitting on the chariot as Arjuna's charioteer. When I see Krishna driving the chariot of Arjuna, this captures my mind.
This Brahmana 就告诉主 Chaitanya,我看见的是主 Krishna 在为 Arjuna 驾驶战车。主 Krishna 为 Arjuna 驾驶战车，这就变成了我的冥想。
Whenever I read the Bhagavad Gita, I simply see Krishna's beautiful features.
无论什么时候，我一旦开始朗读《薄伽梵歌》的时候，我都看到主 Krishna 美丽的、英俊的面庞。
That's why I'm reading Bhagavad Gita. My mind cannot give up. I have to, my mind is attracted. It cannot be distracted from it. My mind is fixed on it. My mind takes pleasure in reading this Bhagavad Gita.
所以当 我朗读《博伽梵歌》的时候，主 Krishna 的美丽的形象就占据了我的脑海，他就不能从我的脑海当中。
So every day I come.
离开我的。
Every day I'm reading.
所以我每一天都在朗读《博伽梵歌》。
So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told the Brahman, yes, you are the authority for reading Bhagavad Gita.
So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 对这位 Brahman 说，是的，你是博伽梵歌的权威。
You understand the real purpose of the Bhagavad Gita.
你能够理解博伽梵歌的真正的要旨。
Material scholarship, that is not so important as devotion.
物质的学识并不如奉爱那么重要。
Many people, they give their scholarly presentation of Bhagavad Gita. It never makes any devotees.
有很多人就对于《博伽梵歌》展开学术的讨论。做出他们学术的文章，但是他们没有制造一位主 Krishna 的奉献者。
But when you hear from the devotee, then there can be the change in heart. Then people can actually take up devotional service.
但是如果聆听了一位从一个纯粹的奉献者那里聆听，他就能改变人的心灵。
So then Lord Chaitanya embraced the Brahmana, and the Brahmana fell at the feet of Lord Chaitanya and began to cry.
之后就 Chaitanya 拥抱了这位 Brahmana, 这位 Brahmana 拜倒在主 Chaitanya 的莲花足下哭泣起来。
And the Brahmana told Lord Chaitanya, I think you are the same Lord Krishna.
这位 Brahmana 对主告诉主 Chaitanya, 我认为您就是同一位 Krishna.
Because the Brahmana had been purified by reading the Bhagavad Gita, so he could understand who Lord Chaitanya actually is.
因为这位 Brahmana 通过朗读《博伽梵歌》得到了净化，他能够理解主 Chaitanya 的真实身份。
So Lord Chaitanya then taught the Brahmana. He taught the Brahmana very thoroughly. He taught him how to read the Bhagavad Gita because people were laughing at him. So Lord Chaitanya taught him, he educated, trained him in reading Bhagavad Gita.
然后主 Chaitanya 就开始教这位 Brahmana 怎么朗读，因为这位 Brahmana 他没有受过教育，受到很多人的嘲讽，所以主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 就开始教导他怎样朗读。
So this way the Brahmana became a great devotee of Lord Chaitanya. And as long as Lord Chaitanya stayed there in Sri Rangam, he stayed there for 4 months, that Brahmana was always with him.
就这样，这位 Brahmana 成为主 Chaitanya 的伟大奉献者。当主 Chaitanya 在四月雨季期间在 Sri Ranga 的停留在那里的时候，每一天这位 Brahmana 都陪伴着主 Chaitanya。
So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu stayed at the house of the Venkata Bhatta, at the Bhatta family, the one who was a pujari. He stayed with them and talked with them about Krishna.
主 Chaitanya 就在四月雨季期间居住在Venkata Bhattacharya 家中，和他的家人就讨论 Krishna 的体质。
So the Ramanuja people, they worship the deity of Lakshmi and Narayan.
Ramanuja Charya 的追随者，他们崇拜 Lakshmi 和 Narayan 的神像。
The main deity in Sri Rangam, there's a reclining deity. Lord Ranganath is laying down. So he is Lord Narayan. He's known as Ranganath, but he's laying down and he has Lakshmi by his side. She's massaging him.
在虚中的庙当中的主神是一个躺着的主威士奴的神像，他是 Narayana。 他幸运女神就在他的足下在为他按摩。
So Lord Chaitanya was very satisfied to see the devotion which Venkatabhata had for Lakshmi Narayan。
主产天念妈妈，我见到 Venkata Bhattacharya 对于 Lakshmi 和 Narayan 的奉爱之情就感到非常满意。
So Lord Chaitanya and the Brahmana Venkata Bhatta, they became very friendly.
主产天念和 Venkata Bhatta 变成了非常亲，他们关系变得非常亲密。
And they would exchange jokes and talk together, and they enjoyed each other's company.
他们的谈话有的时候就开起玩笑，他们就非常享受彼此的陪伴。
So Lord Chaitanya said to the Bhatta, Venkata Bhatta, he said, "You worship Lakshmi, the goddess of fortune." And she's always on the chest of Lord Narayan.
主柴丹尼亚就对 Venkatabhata 说道，你崇拜 Lakshmi， 而 Lakshmi 呢，她总是处在主 Narayan 的胸膛。
She is definitely the most chaste woman in the creation.
幸运女神无疑是整个创造当中最贞洁的女子了。
So Lord Chaitanya said, "My Lord is Sri Krishna, and he is a cowherd boy. He's taking care of the cows. Why is it Lakshmi, who is a chaste woman, wants to associate with Krishna?"
而我的主是 Shri Krishna， 他只是一个牧牛童，为什么整个创造当中最贞洁的女子想要去和一个牧牛童联谊呢？
Lakshmi gave up all the happiness of Vaikuntha for a long time, and she came to do austerities to get association with Krishna.
Lakshmi 放弃了白昆特的富裕，从事长时间的苦行，想要得到主 Krishna 的联谊。
And Lord Chaitanya quoted a verse from the scriptures telling about this.
主 Chaitanya 就从经典引述了经典当中的诗节来叙述这一点。
So when Venkatabhata heard this, he said,Oh, Lord Krishna, Lord Narayan are the one and the same.
Venkatabhata 听完这番话就说道 Oh, 主 Krishna, 主 Narayana, 他们是一个人。
But the pastimes of Krishna are more attractive, more pleasing than the pastimes of Lord Narayan.
但是主 Krishna 的消时光要比主 Narayana 的消时光更吸引人。
And because Krishna and Narayana are the same, Lakshmi's association with Krishna doesn't affect her chastity.
因为主 Krishna 主 Narayana 是同一个人，所以幸运女神要跟主 Krishna 联谊并不影响她的贞洁。
She just wanted to enjoy the fun of associating with Krishna because Krishna has a lot of fun with his pastime. So she wanted to enjoy that fun with him.
因为主 Krishna 的消时光当中有很多的快乐，因此幸运女神也想享受这一番的快乐。
Yeah, there's no difference between the form of Narayan and the form of Krishna. Narayan has four arms and Krishna has two arms, but they're the same personality. But there's some special attraction in Krishna, special dealings which are not there in Narayan. And the goddess of fortune, she said, she thought that if I associate with Krishna, she wanted to enjoy the rasa dance. She wanted that. She wanted to take part in the rasa dance. So that's why she went to do austerity.
幸运女神,
so Venkatabhata told Lord Chaitanya, he said, if Mother Lakshmi wants to enjoy transcendental bliss, it's not wrong, it's not a fault on her part.
Venkatabhata就说道, 超然的快乐的话,
Lord Chaitanya said, yes, I know there's no fault on her part, but still, she couldn't get into the rasa dance.
主持人随后说道,
There's evidence in the scriptures describing how the goddess of fortune is not allowed that pleasure of dancing in the Rasa Leela, like the gopis. Why could she not get in the rasa dance? The personified Vedas entered the rasa dance and associated with Krishna. They followed in the footsteps of the gopis, so they took part in the rasa dance. So Lord Chaitanya asked Venkatabhata, why your goddess of fortune couldn't get in the rasa dance? Venkatabhata said, I don't know. He said, I'm just an ordinary human being. I'm not God. You're God, you may know.
Venkatabhata回答说,我不知道,我只是一个普通人,我不是神,你是神,你知道,您知道。
So Lord Chaitanya said that Krishna has a special characteristic that attracts everyone's heart by this conjugal love. If you want to get the shelter of Krishna, you have to develop the mood of the people of Vrindavan.
Vrindavan居民的心态.
people of Vrindavan, they do not know Krishna as the Supreme Personality of Godhead. They only know him as the son of Nanda Maharaj. And for some people in Vrindavan, they see him as a friend, and some people, they play with him and they climb on his shoulders. And some Mother Yashoda, she can tie up Krishna and tie him to the mortar, to the mortar for churning the butter. So people of Vrindavan, they don't think anything about, they don't think about God, they just think about Krishna. So this is the special mood of Vrindavan, and this is the mood of the gopis. If you want to enter into that mood of Vrindavan, you have to have that spontaneous devotion, this raga bhakti. So the personified Vedas, they couldn't do it at first, but at the, later they understood. They had to give up their bodies and they had to take birth in the family of gopis. And they had to take up actual birth as a gopi. It wasn't enough to just have the mood of the gopis. They actually had to take a birth in the family of Vrindavan and be a gopi. And this way they were able to take part to get into Krishna's Rasa Leela. There's no other way you can get the association of Krishna. But Lakshmi, she couldn't do that. She wanted to enjoy Krishna's company, but she wanted to keep her form as Lakshmi.
但是幸运女神她是做不到这一点的她既想加入到Krishna的Rasa之舞同时呢又想保持自己的作为幸运女神的身份。She
did not follow in the footsteps of the gopis. She worshipped Krishna, but she didn't worship them the way the gopis of Vrindavan worship Krishna.
并没有追随牧牛姑娘的步伐。
So we see Lord Shiva one time, Lord Shiva wanted to also dance Rasa Leela. They told him, you have to become a gopi, then you can dance.
那你必须成为一位勾匹才可以。
So Lord Shiva was told to take a bath in this lake, and he took a bath in the lake, and he came out as a gopi, and then he went in Rasa Leela.
主师要告被告知，你必须要在这个湖中沐浴，然后你就变成一位勾匹牧牛姑娘，之后你可以加入 Rasa 之舞。
So there's a deity of Lord Shiva there in Vrindavan, and they dress him as a gopi because they know Lord Shiva had this pastime.He took part in the Rasa Leela. He became a gopi so he could dance in Rasa Leela.
在本大门有一尊主 Shiva 的神像，他们把主 Shiva 的这尊神像就穿扮成牧牛姑娘，因为他们知道主 Shiva 拥有这个愿望，所以，在主 Shiva 沐浴之后，他成为一位勾匹，得以加入主 Krishna 的 Rasa 之舞。
And similarly, Narada Muni, he also has a form as a gopi, becomes Naradi, so that he can also take part in Rasa Leela.
同样的 Narada Muni, 他也想加入 Rasa 之舞，他成为了 Naradi, 就他在沐浴之后也变成一位gopi, 牧牛姑娘。
Okay, so we will stop here.
那今天我们就讲到这里。
Are there any questions?
索尼提巴特吉，你在房，你现在已经进到这里面了。你的问题是你自己说呢，还是我给你念呢？你要不方便念，我就帮你念吧。
好，你帮我念。
啊，你念啊。你念吧，你打开了，你会。
我不行，我不能跟他说，如果打开来，我就不会念下去了。那个是写出来的，我背不来。
好。
我背不来，对，那个脑袋瓜不行了。
是吧？好，我看看，我把你那个找到。对，这是苏尼提马特吉，他想询问，自从我聆听到心脏部位的音震和多念圈数后，出现异常的现象，不管我处在什么状况、什么地点，只要念诵圣名或者唱诵圣名，或者与奉献者联谊时，只要提到与奉献者一起谈论 Krishna 的话题，都会不由自主的要哭的现象。其实我念诵圣名还不是很专注，也没有觉得特别爱 Krishna， 惭愧。请问 Gurudev， 这种情况属于正常吗？应该如何正确的纠正？虔诚的顶拜 Gurudev 的莲花主，因为我患有海默症，幸亏 Guru 和 Krishna 的仁慈，虽然口齿不清，但是人能记住念诵圣名，这就是他的问题。Good morning， 马德金。
OK， 就是
太长
了。This mother said that since she had heard about the holy name and about the vibration from the heart, and each time when she began to chant, she felt she cannot help but crying. Is this a normal? How to correct this situation? And although I have got the disease of this nerve disease.And although I cannot very clearly by the mercy of Guru Krishna, I can still chant. So this is the pressure.
Well, we hear about Lord Chaitanya crying also, different devotees crying, the Brahmana surrenders to Lord Chaitanya's lotus feet and also cries. And so crying is not uncommon in Krishna consciousness.
我们聆听到朱彩丹尼亚妈妈布他会哭泣，奉献者也会哭泣，在讲课当中，那些 Brahmana 他们也会哭泣，所以在 Krishna 知觉当中哭泣，这个是正常现象，这并不是罕见的。
But you have to keep chanting, you have to give full attention to the chanting of the holy name and pray that the chanting will help you to fix your mind on Krishna.
但是你要继续念诵，专注的念诵，祈祷，你的念诵能够帮助你把心意专注在Krishna身上。
The crying does not mean that you're perfect in Krishna consciousness.
哭泣，并 just
because you're crying, it's not very significant.
哭泣并不代表着你在Krishna这些当中就完美了。 哭泣并不是很重要，这个现象。
What is important is that you do a lot, you do service for Krishna.
重要的是您为Krishna做服务。
And that's chanting the holy name and hearing scriptures and discussing philosophy with devotees.
唱诵圣名，聆听经典，跟奉献者讨论。
So keep chanting, and Gaura Govinda Maharaj, he wanted to have a school. He wanted to make a school for crying to educate people that they could cry for Krishna. So if you're crying for Krishna, that's good.
Gaura Govinda Maharaj said, if you cannot, you can cry for Krishna, that's good, right?
Yeah.
Gaura Govinda Maharaj 说，如果能够为 Krishna 哭泣，那是很好的。Yeah,
he wanted to have a school for crying to educate people how to cry for Krishna.
想开办一所哭泣学校，教会人们如何为 Krishna 哭泣。Because
usually we can cry for money, we can cry for our family, you can cry for your husband, you can cry for your son, but you don't cry for Krishna.
因为人们会为失去钱财哭泣，失去亲人哭泣，为失去丈夫哭泣，失去儿子哭泣，却不会为 Krishna 哭泣。
So this is a problem.
这个是个问题。
Yeah, we want to cry for Krishna that, oh, I've wasted my life not cultivating Krishna consciousness.
我们希望为 Krishna 哭泣，哦，我的一生都浪费了，我并没有去培养 Krishna 之觉，我都浪费了我的光阴。I've
spent so much of my life in sense, having sense gratification, and never developed love for Krishna.
我把光阴都浪费在感官享乐上面，我并没有把时间花在。
So we should cry about this. We should cry that we're separate from Krishna, that Krishna's gone, Krishna's, that we're separate from Krishna. We want to be with Krishna. We should be praying, when will Krishna come? When will Krishna come? When will Krishna come to see me? We want to be with Krishna. So when we think like that, that is good, that is spiritual progress. Okay, is there any other question?
这里还有一个问题。 是夏曼拉尼, 呼和浩特的夏曼拉尼, 马太吉, 想问咕噜一个问题。 他在Facebook上面看咕噜的直播, 他的问题是, 在歪坤他的五种关系中, 没有自发的爱吗? 如果有, 和格洛卡文达文的有什么不同?
Yeah, so...
There...
Go ahead.
Yes. Yes, Mara.
So, usually that spontaneous devotion is there, that's a mood of Goloka. Vaikuntha, everything is according to regulative principles. It's called Vaidhi Sadhana Bhakti. So everything is done according to rules and regulations and very formal. But in Vrindavan, everything is spontaneous, there's spontaneous, natural, loving devotion. So Lord Chaitanya, he came to give this raga bhakti, this mood of spontaneous devotion for Krishna. Lord Chaitanya wants all of us to go to Goloka, to be with Krishna in Vrindavan. So it's a special mood of Goloka, that it's bhava, you have to have that raga bhakti, bhava bhakti, raga bhakti, the natural loving attraction for Krishna. Just like I said, that they think of Krishna as the son of Nanda Maharaj, they don't think of him as God. In Vaikuntha, he's God. Personality of Godhead, but in Goloka, he's the son of Nanda Maharaj.
So, in Vrindavan, they don't see Krishna as God, just like in the lecture, they all see Krishna as Nanda Maharaj's son. So, to go to Goloka, they have to cultivate Radha Bhakti.
Yeah. Okay, is there any other question now?
Guru Mahani Maharaji, 你看那个窗口很有几个问题。
好的。聊天窗口。第一个有一个问题是来自于Manini Radha，顶拜Maharaj。 您提到主希瓦那拉达穆尼韦达经的人格化身，纷纷获得了牧牛姑娘的躯体，加入了拉萨之舞。请问
投生为木牛姑娘的资格是什么？
成为木牛姑娘的资格是什么？
The qualification to be born as a gopi.
So, yeah, you have to desire to actually want to take birth in the family of the gopis. You have to absorb your mind in thinking about gopis, and somehow you have, you know, we say whatever you think of at the time of death, you go there, you know, that's where you go. So when we give up the body, you have to think about Vrindavan and the gopis, and then you can take birth as a gopi.
你有愿望，就是在那，就像佛家梵高说的，无论人临死的时候想着什么情景，他下一生就到达那个情景。如果想投生为木牛姑娘，就要把心意专注于这个木牛姑娘的身上，让你临死的时候想着木牛姑娘，就能投生为木牛姑娘。The next one?
Yeah.
下一个 Krishna Balarama Das， 请问 Maharaj， Venkata Bhatta 为何能够得到主四个月的联谊？Rang the Chetra 是马哈帕布南印度之旅中待的时间最长的地方吗？
Yes, he stayed the longest time. That's true, because it was Chaturmasya, so he stayed there for 4 months. So that was the longest he stayed. Usually other places he didn't stay very long.
是的，因为是四月雨季，所以他待了四个月，一般来说他不会停留这么久。
It's a rule for sannyasi, particularly Lord Chaitanya's sannyasi in those days, the sannyasis, because they walk everywhere, so in the rainy season you cannot walk. So they would just stay in one place and they would do austerity for 4 months.
对于散家子来说这是一个规则，但因为是下雨，所以他们就无法旅行，他们就待在一个地方，在那里苦行。
We see pictures of Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati Prabhupada during Chaturmasya. He would grow a beard, he wouldn't shave, they don't cut the nails, they don't cut the hair, and they only eat one meal a day, and sometimes that's also restricted. They do different types of austerity. They chant many rounds, 64 rounds every day.
我们看到有一幅 Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati 他过的照片，他的胡子很长，就在四月苦行期间呢，有的时候有人们会不剪指甲，不剪头发，一天只吃一顿饭，念64圈，就从事特定的苦行。
So Lord Chaitanya.
The next one.
Yeah. Okay. Lord Chaitanya just stayed there for 4 months, because Chaturmasya, he gave the association. It was a nice temple to stay at. It's a big temple.
Next one.
所以这主柴丹尼亚的仁慈，他停留了四个月给予他联谊，而且这所庙宇是一所南印度一种非常好的非常棒的庙，
很大
很宏伟的一所庙宇。
OK， 还有问题吗？
还有一个问题，下一个问题是 Radharani Devadasi， Radharani Devadasi 的问题，放下自己所有的执着，并不是自己和 Krishna 直接联系。
前面还有。
啊啊，哦哦 ，sorry， 哦对不起。 漏掉了两个问题，遗憾顶拜孤，怎么才能让自己培养起文达文居民的心态呢？ How to cultivate the mood of Vrindavan?
Well, you have to hear about Vrindavan. You have to hear all the pastimes of Krishna and Vrindavan and hear about the gopis and the Rasa Leela and all the activities which take place there.
您需要聆听 Krishna, 需要聆听 Vrindavan, 聆听 gopi, 聆听 Krishna 在 Vrindavan 的逍遥时光。
When the month of Kartik comes, we worship Lord Damodar, we hear about Mother Yashoda and how she's taking care of Krishna.
当 Kartik 月来的时候，我们就聆听到有关于Yashoda妈妈和 Krishna 之间的逍遥时光。
So we need to hear about Krishna and Krishna's gopis, the gopis, the cowherd boys. We can hear about all the people of Vrindavan.
我们需要聆听 Krishna, gopi, 还有牧牛童，还有 Vrindavan 的所有的居民。
You may be attracted to one particular devotee in Vrindavan, so you can absorb, think more about them.
您可能就会对被 Vrindavan 的某一个特定的人物所吸引，从而对这个就聆听更多这个人的事情。The next one.
Yes.
是 Hare Krishna, Sharadiya Devadasi. Hare Krishna, 顶拜 Guru, 这次在北京庙里跟 Guru 和奉献者联谊，得到了巨多仁慈。今天听您的讲课，感觉听到了最高机密的绝对真理。我想请教您，我们追随勾屁的步伐，不把神当作神，并且能够从内心自发的对 Krishna 有爱，关于勾屁身体我们应该怎么做，保持什么心态？
这个问题是 Radha Rani Devadasi 通过 Saradila 问的。
Well, we already answered that. Somebody asked about how to get the body of the gopi. We already spoke about.
那这因为刚才有奉献者提到了这个问题，这个我们已经回答了，有关于 gopi 的身体。
Yeah.
下一个问题 ，the next one.
Yeah.
放下执着。We put down, we give up our attachment. And we don't associate with Krishna directly, but we are willing to see Radha and Krishna together. We are satisfied to serve them.And we do service for the satisfaction of Radha and Krishna. About this mood of gopi, I want to hear more from Guru.
Did you read the Chinese yet?
Yes, just now I have read it, but I can read it again.这个是来自于 Radha Rani 的 David Dasi 的问题。放下自己的执着，不是说自己想和 Krishna 直接联谊，而是从心里头愿意看到 Radha Krishna 在一起，为他们服务就感到很满足，为了 Radha Krishna 的心意去服务。这种心 Gopi 的这种心态，还想听 Guru 说多一些。
Well, you read the, you read the yourself. You read the 10th canto Srimad Bhagavatam. You read about Rasa Leela, and you read the Gopi Gita, the chapter Gopi Gita, chapter 31 of the 10th canto, the songs of the gopis, how the gopis are looking for Krishna. You read this, there's so many chapters there in the 10th canto describing about the gopis and their mood and service to Krishna.
您自己就是读《博伽瓦坛》第十篇，第31章 Gopi Gita, Gopi 之歌, Gopi 们怎么寻找 Krishna, Gopi 们的那种心态, 您自己可以去阅读。
Yeah, there's many chapters, there's many things you have to read, you can read and relish yourself. We don't have time today to discuss all this.
在《博伽瓦坛》第十篇当中有很多章都涉及到这一点，您可以自己在下面花时间去阅读，我们在这里没有很多时间讨论这一点。
Is there any more question?
还有一个 Krishna Bala Ramadas Dimbai Maharaj 在这个普鲁舍塔满月，我们可以只吃以他的西餐吗？ 这样做有什么好处呢？
There's no special benefit in doing that.
这么做没有特殊的好处。
You get benefit by eating Krishna prasadam.
您是通过吃 Krishna prasadam 得到好处的。
But you can control your eating, you can reduce your eating, if you like, restrict your eating. But the purpose is to do more chanting and to do more devotional service.
您可以控制自己的饮食，减少食量，但是要点就是更多的念诵，做更多的服务。
Simply fasting is material.
He said only eat ekadasi.
I know what he said. He said only eat ekadasi, but that's fasting from grains. That is also material.
只吃以大利斯餐，这也是物质的。
So you don't make spiritual advancement just by doing some material thing. You have to do more bhakti, hearing, chanting.
物质的活动是不能得到灵性的好处的，是需要更多的聆听、唱诵，需要更多的 bhakti 奉爱。
Yes, was there another part to his question?
You have covered all this. The other part is Dimbai Maharaj, 主 Shiva 是 Prabhu, 怎么和 Krishna 跳 Rasa 之舞呢? 怎么理解主 Shiva 和 Krishna 之间这种情感? 他真的能像木牛姑娘们一起跳舞吗?
Yes, Lord Shiva took a bath in the Kund and he came out with the body of a gopi, so that he could go to Rasa Leela.
是的，主Shiva在一个困的，你的湖中沐浴，出来之后，他就有一个gopi木牛姑娘的形体了，他就得以，就是以这个gopi的形体跟 Krishna 跳 Rasa 之舞。
But Lord Krishna understood what was happening and he told Lord Shiva, this is not proper.
但是主Krishna，他觉察到了发生的事情，所以他就跟主Shiva说，这，this is not good,
yeah, not,
right?
It's not proper, you shouldn't be doing this, you shouldn't be coming in the Rasa Leela.
所以主Krishna就跟他说，这并不恰当, 你不应该这样做，你不应该这样来跳 Rasa 之舞。
But he got the name Lord Shiva is called Gopeshwara, and the deity of Lord Shiva in Vrindavan is there is called Gopeshwara, means the Lord of the Gopis.
主 Shiva 得到了一个名字叫 Gopeshwara, 就是他在 Vrindavan, 他是以这个 Gopi 的主人而著称。
And they dress the deity of Lord Shiva as a gopi.
他们把主 Shiva 的神像穿扮成了一个 gopi 牧牛姑娘。
Okay. It's a special pastime of Lord Shiva.
这是主 Shiva 的特殊逍遥时光。
All right. Is there any other final question?
No, only Panchatara Das said, thank you so much for your mercy, dear Maharaj.
Thank all the devotees for listening and for their participation.
感谢所有奉献者聆听和参与。
Okay, 我们明天见。我们感谢 Guru Mani 给我们讲台的翻译。感谢Tanaka Prabhu Jujur, 感谢所有的奉献者聆听。明天见。
谢谢马尔阿芝。
Hare Krishna。
Hare Krishna。
谢谢马尔。辛苦了。辛苦了。
谢谢马尔。我在礼拜两方中辛苦了。
Hare Krishna。
Hare Krishna。
Hare Krishna。